linebacker Jackson Taylor, head coach Ryan Carty, and tight end Braden Brose. Go ahead with questions for Coach.
How's it feel, Coach?
It feels pretty awesome. It does. I mean, you know, obviously, just it feels prideful. You know, I'm very, very proud right now. I mean, the way that we fought and everything that we kind of talked about last night and then talked about at halftime again, and that, you know, anything worth doing is going to be hard and it's going to have challenges, and we're going to have to persevere through them in order to have the outcome that we want and the success that we want. And we just need to take it one snap at a time, because that's all that we are guaranteed now. And the way that we believed in it and believed in each other, that we were just going to make the next play, is, you know, it's culture defining and confirming, and it's very prideful for me to witness it firsthand.
Hey, Coach, if you're going to fall behind by 21, I guess you couldn't do it in the second quarter. I mean, what was the feeling at halftime, you know, in terms of, hey, okay, like, you know, we've had a rough start here, but we can do this?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a matter of belief in our ability to, you know, to score points fast and to stop people. I mean, it's just a matter of doing the things and executing properly. It wasn't like we, you know, we shot ourselves in the foot a little bit in the first half. I mean, I was told by the announcers on my postgame interview that it was 4 turnovers and 4 possessions, which I didn't know. I actually, because we won, I got a chance to giggle at that one. That's silly. I mean, that's something that doesn't happen very often. And obviously to a team that, you know, has usually a pretty good grasp of ball security. And so I think that, you know, to overcome those things is really just a matter of focus, intention, and then making sure that, you know, when we go out there, we execute well. We do, you know, on defense, we play 11-man football. We just start running the ball, and that's when we started creating some turnovers. And then, obviously, you know, once Nick settled down a little bit, I think, you know, he just played an unbelievable game.
Yeah, that kind of leads into my next question. But I mean, he looked like a better quarterback, a more experienced quarterback in the second half. He's pretty polished in the conference.
Guys, I tell you what, I don't know. I'm very proud of him, because that is not an easy situation that he got thrust into. Matt, to be the first true freshman to start a game in the University of Delaware since 2001. Thanks for that stat, Kev. You know, to do it in a playoff game and not be the backup the whole year, even the third string, fourth string quarterback at times. He's been in a situation where he has not taken a lot of reps this year, since fall camp. Like, that's when he got the bulk of his reps. And that's not easy, to go in there and just take mental reps and come prepared every day, take notes in meetings every day, knowing that your time might come. Because most of the time it doesn't. And then we sit back there and we regret all those times that we didn't take notes very well and we didn't pay attention to film and the mistakes that somebody else was making. And to know that he obviously was, really is just a sense of pride as a coach. I think, you know, our coaching staff did a great job getting him prepared this week. And obviously he did a great job preparing. And then once he settled in, I mean, he's talented. He can make every throw. And, you know, those turnovers weren't all his fault either. He had a couple that were just bad breaks. And, you know, I think to be able to overcome that and just keep playing football is not easy, in particular in your first start. You know, that could have snowballed for someone who doesn't have the mental fortitude that he obviously did. And so I think it's also a credit to the people and the leaders on our team and the people around him. You know, you look into Jackson's eyes, you look into the defensive guys' eyes, the offensive line, guys like Braden. There was not a sense at all that he wasn't going to go win this game for us. And so, you know, I think that's just a testament to who we are as a unit. And then, obviously, what he did to prepare himself for this situation. So, really proud.
Braden, what were the hugs like down the center? Everything that obviously mattered so much. And what helped
you know, we're always comfortable. We trust our offense, and you know, we're just resilient. You know, we every play we know what we're gonna do, and we execute, and that's just it. And if we don't get too high or too low, we're always ready to go.
Yeah, and after that one play, I guess in the first half, you kind of boxed him out. Do you feel like that was a good go-to then? You got that chance to do it in the second half.
Yeah, no, I should have had that, but. You know, I was glad I got to make it up, so I was happy.
You and Nick looked like you were playing quarterback and receiver together for years. I mean, you know, the comfort throw, and did you kind of feel that on knows where I'm going to be, and I know where he's going to be.
Yeah, definitely. We worked all week. I actually, during camp, I would always mess with him and say, like, oh, you never throw me the ball. You know, get it out of his mind. So, we worked all week. We worked extra and executed good. So.
I just want to ask, obviously it comes down to a field goal, which hasn't been the easiest thing in the last couple of years. You just talked about executing that, you know, when you absolutely had to have it.
Yeah, extremely excited for Alex Schmoke to be able to, you know, it hasn't been an easy road, I don't think, for Alex. I mean, he came in here with, you know, a pedigree and an All-American coming in and missed a couple of kicks early, that's all, you know, and we all do that. We all have times where we you know, make a couple, basically just execution errors, right? And not all things are kicker's fault either. Sometimes there's a snap, sometimes there's a hole, sometimes there's a little bit of rush and, he didn't lose his job, but he was kicking extra points for us, and Nate was doing a little bit better kicking those field goals, and there was just something about it. I just had a feeling that he was going to go hit that one for us, and I'm really proud that he went out there and proved me right, because that would have been a tough one if he didn't. But, man, was that a pretty great kick. I mean, we did a great job setting it up, good ball security, getting the ball in the middle of the field for him, and he just knocked that thing right through. Also, unbelievable job. On the snap and the hold and the protection, because obviously they were going after it at that point.
Right. Did he know he was going to be the guy?
No.
Okay. Like, what did you roughly?
Before that last play. So, we knew we were going to run the ball. And right. So, you know, we told, you know, Coach D'Amico came over and asked who I wanted. And, it was more – he's been kicking all of our extra points for the past – I mean, he's been almost automatic, obviously, in this one today. Right on cue. But it was his first miss of the year, I think, on an extra point. And so that was, you know, we tried to set it up, and it was basically an extra point distance. So I thought it would be great for him to be able to go out there and just kind of do what he's been prepping for this whole season. So pretty awesome to see those guys step up and make plays when it was necessary.
Can you talk about what it's like playing for you?
100 tackles this season, first time in his career, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I learned.
Coming here and playing in this atmosphere, an FCS playoff game,
I mean, it was definitely special. Wasn't like a crazy packed game, but you know, it was definitely the atmosphere was in the, you know, it was in the air. You could feel it. You know, it was a lot of tension because you know, today could have been a lot of guys' last game, so. Definitely wanted to make sure we just played this one for each other and stick together.
Could you just talk about the defensive ability to force turnovers in the second half? I mean, obviously, you're always trying to force turnovers, but you had a lot of success after halftime.
Yeah, I mean, it's time to make a play. You know, we're down. Got to step up to the plate. You know, a lot of our guys were able to do that.
Coach, what did you see from the Lafayette strength that you needed to get a few of them after?
Well, I think they did a good job in the first half at kind of, I don't know if it was just the right calls or just guessing right. You know, there's times in a football game, offensive and defensive coordinators kind of go at it, and there's times where you just guess wrong and guess right on each other. And, I think early in the game, they had clouded the correct side based on the play that we had called a couple of times and rolled the coverage that way, and they kind of got us. And as a reaction, I think we, you know, at halftime kind of adjusted pretty well and made sure that we found some ways to kind of get some space for our guys in the pass game. And I think it was really more possibly me, too. I mean, I probably could have thrown the ball a little bit more early. I was trying to get Nick to kind of get ease into the game a little bit. And we were just kind of getting hit on some of those third and shorts where, you know, we maybe here or there didn't get what we needed. And so... once I realized that at this point it is what it is, we're going to win or lose because Nick's throwing the ball well, because that's what's, you know, what we're great at and what the defense was giving us, you know, we just had to go kind of, you know, throw it on the table. And then he just did a great job, and the boys made great catches. I mean, that catch that Josh Youngblood had at the end of the half to kind of get some momentum going into the half, man, was that a nice throwing catch. And, I think that two-minute drive really added, you know, you guys asked about what Nick did to settle down. I mean, just having that two-minute drive at the end of the half to really, you know, solidify the fact that he can be here and he can make plays in a playoff game, I think really helped him going into the half. That, you know, it was kind of a different kid coming out of that locker room.
Coach,
Coach, the other side of that coin, though, is in the second half, but the running game really started to hit.
That's how it works, isn't it?
With a third and fourth team running
back. Complimentary football, right? I mean, we've talked about it all year. It doesn't mean that we just got to run at the throw. You know, it could be throwing to run, and that's what it did. You know, as we started to open it up a little bit better and they realized that they needed to cover a little bit more, now all of a sudden we had some rush lanes. And if we can stay, keep people off balance, you know, we're going to be a really tough offense to defend.
How proud are you of it?
Yeah, I mean, we've talked about it a bunch in here. You know, the next man up mentality only matters when that next man up is good enough and is prepared enough. And what you saw from our team, because, I mean, shoot, in the secondary at one point during this game, when we were stopping them and getting turnovers and finishing the game, we had three true freshmen out there and a true freshman playing quarterback and a redshirt freshman playing running back. And so I think that's something that you really have to see is belief in the talent that we have and belief in, you know, the ability for our coaches to get those guys ready to go and then belief in each other around them that all we have to do is do our 111 and we're going to go out there and be okay. Do you like my jacket, Dean Kamer? Do you see this thing?
Oh, you're going to like it.
I'll show it to you later. What you got? I did see it. I did. I thought it was tough. He was tough doing it. The ref also said might have been a blindside block, and he probably should have scraped the paint. But we don't really go over that in the quarterback meetings as much. It's more of a, you know, a special teams thing and a receivers thing. You know, you get called the blindside block in the quarterback, it's going to be a rarity. And so I'm glad they didn't throw it. But he was like, hey, he was close. I said, okay, I'll talk to him for the next time it happens.
Just talk about the feeling right now. I mean, you guys are down 28-7, and really nothing was going right. And it's the playoffs, and here you are, you know, winning.
It's awesome. You know, it could have been my last game. But, we played in games where we've been down and we came back. So, you know, it's nothing new for us. We can work through anything. And
It's a little
awesome.
Different, though.
Yeah.
Things were different
not
going
that
way.
Just
got to
keep calm.
Hey, Braden, if you play FCS football and you're playing up well, you might earn a trip to Montana to play Montana at some point. That's what you guys just earned. You know, what does that mean to you guys to get to go out there and, you know, and play, you know, a school that, like Delaware, is kind of one of the FCS legendary names?
Yeah, it's awesome. You know, if you want to be the best, you got to beat the best. You know, we're ready to take that back. So,
Coach Bill, was that early fumble from Marcus? Is that one of the reasons you didn't look for it? Or was there some kind of
I think I just benched Marcus Yarns for one fumble. No, he fumbled. That was unrelated to him not playing. Yeah, he's still dealing with a lower body thing. So, it's unfortunate.
You guys don't have time at all anymore? Or no.
Not
for the season?
Thanks, guys.
Congratulations, guys.
Appreciate you guys. So cool.